Hey everybody, it's me Jill, and welcome to Jill Informed. This is a recap of The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills, Season 8, Episode 1, Stronger Than Ever. I hope everybody has had a wonderful Christmas and you are enjoying whatever holidays you celebrate, wherever you are with your families and having a good time. I'm gonna make this brief so that I can spend some time with my family. But the new season of Beverly Hills just started, so I wanted to talk about it a little bit and give you the taglines. Let's start with the taglines. Okay, Kyle's is, "In this town, fame and money come and go, but friends should not." That feels awkward to me somehow. And kind of boring. And kind of Kyle. In comparison, this one's Erica's. "Some people call me cold, but that's not ice, it's diamonds." Yeah, girl. I love her. I love her. Dorit, "I believe in an excess of everything, except moderation." Okay, I get it. Teddy Mellencamp, this is the new one, who's also John Mellencamp's daughter. "Having the best isn't important to me, but being the best is." Oh, sweetie. These women are going to eat you alive. You're in Beverly Hills. Having the best better be important to you. Take Lisa Rinna's, for example. "I don't have to buy it because I already own it." Yeah, you do. People hate on her so much. I cannot. I love Lisa Rinna. And finally, the queen of all queens, Lisa Vanderpump. "The queen of diamonds always has an ace up her sleeve." You know, again, I get it, but you've done better, Lisa. Anyway, what did you guys think of the taglines? Leave a comment down below and let me know whose was your favorite. Okay, so the episode, again, I said I was going to be brief because there wasn't a lot. This was just sort of an establishing thing and really mainly to, I think, introduce Teddy Mellencamp, who is our new housewife this season. We start off with Erica being Erica Jane in all her glory, and I'm sorry, I love her. Every aspect of her, I love every ridiculous moment. She is way over the top, but in such a good way. As of right now, I can say no wrong. But the season has just begun. And you know what? I loved Siggy Flicker season one. Season two, Siggy? I mean, that woman went off the rails. I can't imagine anything would make me not like Erica Jane, but the season is young. Okay, the season with Rinna is her and her daughters who are now both models, and Lisa is like Kris Jenner light. And I'm hoping that her whole season isn't gonna be her being the momager to her daughters and their modeling careers. But we'll see. Kyle is trying to plan a Vegas trip for the ladies because it's all their birthdays around the same time. Well, not all of them, but Lisa Rinna, Dorit, and Erica all have birthdays kind of all around the same time. And Kyle thought it would be fun to have a Vegas trip. So she's trying to make that happen. In the meantime, Dorit is over at Teddy Mellencamp's house because they have children about the same age. And now Jagger is talking and Teddy runs this like children's music kind of a thing in her house. And she's pretty cool. She's beautiful and she's definitely a tomboy. She talked about not liking to shop for clothes and stuff. So I'm not exactly sure how well she is going to fit in with this group of ladies because she seems a lot different to me, but you know, she's brand new. Dorit wants to introduce her to Lisa Vanderpump because she mentioned that she loves horses and riding horses, and so does Lisa Vanderpump. So they go to have lunch together, I guess. And one thing leads to another, and they're talking about the Vegas trip, and Teddy mentions that her birthday is the next day. So they're like, oh my gosh, you have to come because it's kind of a mass birthday celebration thing. So she agrees. But the fact that Teddy is being introduced to the group and is kind of bonding with Dorit concerns me greatly. We have the montage of the ladies packing and getting ready for the trip, and Kyle's daughter, Portia, oh my gosh, she is so grown up looking. She's 9 years old right now. I cannot believe how fast she's grown up. Anyway, she's adorable. So all the ladies are going on this Vegas trip, including Camille Grammer. I love Camille. I'd love her to come back as a full-time housewife. Anyway, she's there, and Lisa Rinna ends up meeting them there, I think, because she's got something with her daughters. Nothing really happens. They land, they all get to Vegas, and the ladies are getting ready to go out to a club. And we see Dorit with her hair and makeup girls that she's brought with, and she's acting like she always brings them wherever she goes. I think she's infringing on Erica's glam squad a little bit, because that was always Erica's thing. Dorit and Erica Jane kind of butt heads, so I don't know if there's a little copycat stuff going on or what. Dorit. All the ladies are ready to go out. Ooh, Teddy Mellencamp's outfit was smoking. She's in this little teddy, this little black, like, lacy romper that's see-through, and she's got some little thing underneath. I mean, it's super cute. Don't know that anybody else could really pull that off. And I'm also wondering how old she is. I feel like by far she is going to be the youngest one, which is another reason why I don't feel like they fit in that well. I mean, look at Megan King Edmonds. I don't think she's ever gonna be, if she's even coming back next season, I don't think she's ever gonna be in the center of that group just because of the age difference. Maybe Bravo's trying to bring in some young blood to spice things up and appeal to a wider audience. I don't know, maybe. That was pretty much it. This episode was really just setting up the season, but I think we're in for a good one. I'm looking forward to it because Beverly Hills is one of my favorite. New York is my favorite. Beverly Hills is probably number two. I hope you join me this season because I think we are in for a lot of fun. Thank you so much for watching. Please join me every Tuesday at 1 p.m. Central Time for the next recap of The Real Housewives of Beverly Hills. Please subscribe if you haven't already. Please give me a thumbs up if you liked this episode and comment down below. I love to hear from you guys. Again, everybody, I hope you're having a wonderful holiday. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.